Hi, welcome to World of Braiding and Extensions. And today we're going to be coming to you with something really amazing, something that's been so much sought after. What would this thing be? We'll be looking at the weave. And why is it so exciting? A full head of weave with a side parting. Now that is something that is so well sought after. Because we have so many types of weaves, we have the center parting, which is the natural center parting. So you weave the rest of the hair and you leave the client's hair out. And then when you finish, you open the client's hair and you cover your weave with it. Then we have the lace front weave closure, where a piece of lace is used to create a natural finish. And so that is so popular right now. Then we also have the full closure, where we have what we call the closure weave finish. And that closure weave finish is like a spiral finish, where we continue weaving, and then in the crown, we create what we call the closure. But what we are looking at today is the side parting. And so, my name is Joy Fido, and welcome on board. So why is the full weave side parting so important? You're gonna come across lots of clients who they don't have money to buy this lace closure that gives this natural finish. They don't want to have a fringe. And so when we have a fringe, or what the Americans call a bang, is when you go with that, you know, the spiral closure. So when you do a spiral closure, it's usually very difficult to lift it on the side and create a side opening, because somehow the tracks begin to open and show itself. So we're looking at giving you this side pattern that gives you like a natural look. And the reason this is so important is because, like I said, lots of people don't have money to go and buy this lace closure. Lots of people don't want this bang or fringe, and so they still want an opening, but they don't want to open their hair. So what kind of clients are these? People who have like a full head of natural hair and they don't want to relax their hair or put chemical into their hair to straighten it, or they don't want to use the hot comb to create like a straight look out of the natural hair. So they still want healthy hair, but they want to be able to have hair that looks amazing. So remember what we all stand for. We always standing for natural, healthy hair. We stand for protective hairstyles. We're standing for damage-free hairstyles. So we want to give this client a full head of weave, give her that side parting she wants. We don't want to stress her to go and buy this lace closure. So this is why this is so important and is so well sought after by so many stylists who've been struggling to achieve this style. So we're going to be doing this today, and that's why I'm really excited, because I want you to have this skill that will bring in more clients to you, and then you can start getting your money back. Okay, so as usual, we look at our tools first. And the tool we're working with today is mainly the training head. And that's because we are believing that you're new at this and you still want to get your technique right before you start practicing this on a live client. So we like to take you from the training side. So once you practice this by yourself, then you can go further to try this on a client. But as usual, if you stay in touch with us, with our Instagram page, with our YouTube page, you see that from time to time when we work with clients, we throw these images out. But this is very important for you to get every step of the way with the understanding of what you're doing. And that's why we work with you with the training head, so you are feeling like we are feeling to get this right. So that's the training head. And then the next thing is the hair you'll be working with. So today we're just working with a regular hair. Don't worry yourself about the brand. This is what this hair is like. Now, it is synthetic hair, but it's got very beautiful bounce to it, and that's why I love it. So this hair is, again, just for training. It's synthetic hair, so there will not be any blow drying or flat ironing. because we are also going to do another video with time on a natural side parting where we may use human hair, yes, so that we're going to create like a ability to tongue and flat iron. But we already did something on the full head weave where you have the fringe, and that also gave you the room to be able to blow dry and flat iron. So here is just to focus on the technique itself. So that's why we're working with synthetic hair. So after the synthetic hair is the needle. So very important you have your needle. And then we have your weaving thread, which is very important. There's a scissors as always, because that cuts the thread. And what else could you possibly have? You could have the clip just to help hold some hair when I wouldn't need that. But this is one of my favorite clips. I don't know if you call this the duck clip, but it's some clip that helps a lot to hold hair. So I think that's all we need. We need the brush to brush the hair when we're done. So that's our tools, and so we're ready to go. Okay, so you can notice this is on a very high stand. Generally when you're in class, we work with a regular stand where you just sit on the table, but this one is individual stand where it's on its own, and so that's the head. But the main thing I want you to pick up here is the cornrow technique. So I've gone like that, and then I've taken it here, and I'm going like that. Take it up a bit and come up, go, and then up again. Oh, this time I go there, and then I start going circular. So I'm going circle. So it's circle, and then it goes, and then it comes again with a circle, and it goes, and circle, and it goes, and so that just goes on. You keep going until there's really no hair left. Finish it off. There's a strand of hair normally, and that strand you just insert it into whatever space you find and just stitch it in. That's it. Yeah. So we are believing you already know how to do cornrow, because if you don't, we'll show you a DVD we have on how to create cornrows where you really learn from the beginning. So you know cornrows, and this is what you can do. This is the most important part. You start from there, create your line, start from there and go. And when you get to the end, take a little bit up and go back. Take a little bit up and go back. Take a little bit up. And that's when the circle starts. And so this is what we're going to use as our base. Now, once you're creating the side parting, you need it, because you don't want to be able to have any more space in the front of the hair, so that the hair itself doesn't go and create any confusing finish. So we need a full head of cornrow. Remember we said with a full head of cornrow. So now I'm opening the hair and I'm ready to start. So generally I just put the hair on my shoulder so it's not rolling all over the floor, and then my stitching starts. Okay, so this is the hair from the bag. Now, question I get asked is, do you want to look at the right direction and which one is the wrong direction? There's really no right or wrong in any of them. Sometimes you get the one that's inside and sometimes it's outside. Doesn't really matter. When you're stitching wave, just go on with it. This one's a bit messed up, so I'm going to just nip off the beginning. And so I just take that part that's a bit open out. So I've got a very neat beginning. And so I put it like that. So I'm starting like a quarter way from the beginning, yeah? Your needle comes, straight needle, very straight threading. And so it's a straight line into the thread. See that? It's a single thread. Single thread. Don't go doubling your thread. Single. This is the second part of the thread. But don't pull it to be the same length. Make sure one is longer than the other. Yeah? And that's the best way to get very clean stitching. Because when it's doubled, it makes your stitching, it creates a lot of bump on the hair. So what I've done, this is very important, make your needle face you. Don't let the needle face down. And so I pulled that thread over. You see the one thread. And then I pull again. Now this part of stitching is just regular. If you bought our DVD on doing a full head weave, you are used to this by now. So this is just normal way of doing things. The most important part of this video is when we're going to create the side parting. So I'm going to carry on as normal as possible. So bear with me on that. So now there was a little bit of thread we left hanging out, and that's the thread. So times like this, you could bring your clip and hold this one down so it doesn't keep falling back on you. So now we take that thread and we knot it with the normal one that was in our hands. Why are we knotting? Because remember, we had just one line, one thread, single thread. We didn't double it. So that's been cut off, so it's been knotted now. So now we're going to go forward. The flap that we left open, we're going to use it now. Always check your thread to make sure it's okay, because thread has a habit of knotting itself. So again, this is where I will just take another clip and hold that side down so it doesn't keep bothering me. I can also take a bigger clip and hold this away completely so it doesn't keep coming back on me. So now I'm ready to stitch properly. So needle, the thread will go over the needle. Remember, the needle goes up and the thread comes. So that's it, stitched. I'll go again, thread over the needle, stitched. And this is just the stitching action, nothing new here, if you can weave here. So thread is always over the needle. Now what you're experiencing now, which is this hair going fuzzy, is just because of the synthetic hair. It does that. So I'll push this a little bit. So now I can have where I'm stitching. So remember, the thread is over the needle. I pull through. And I pull through, and so you keep doing that. Sometimes if I find there's a gap there, I can always take that to hold it together. So now that's held in place. I always do that just to give me something of an extra hold. So that very beginning is all completely in now. Now I'm trying to make sure that part does not unravel. And always remember, whenever you're creating a weave, the very beginning is so important, because that's the part that could unravel. So I've got that now completely in place. So I'll go with that thread over that needle a few times. And so that is what is actually sealed. So it's completely knotted now. So now we're going to go backwards. So now we're coming from where we started. So what I've done now is I'm taking it back on myself, and that's what we call double stitching. So double stitching, you're taking it backwards, so it gives you that extra hold on the beginning. So one thing you should pick up, and this is a question I'll be asking a lot of times, is when you're stitching, don't go stitching into the weft. Just take it from underneath the weft. Maybe I'll explain that a bit more. This is the weft, this thing. And so when your needle comes, again, if you're used to stitching, you will know that you don't put your needle into that. Don't do that. Just stay outside of it. Outside of it. So outside of the weft, pick up your cornrow and that's it. So mainly what's happening is the weft is sandwiched between the cornrow. See? So from under, and you pick the other side of the cornrow, and the weft is just in between. And that's it. So now we're at the angle, we're going to lift it a bit up, just like that cornrow started. See, that cornrow went a bit up. So now I'm going to turn that line backwards. So I've done that. So now it's going to come up. And just fold it and goes like that. Our second weft. So I'm going to start stitching now. Okay, so you can see how far I've gone halfway, and then that got there. So now I'm going that way. Look at how clean these stitches are. You're meant to just go up and pull, up and pull. So it stays very straight and very firm. What you don't do is leave the thread halfway slack. So I'm showing you this because this is the next stage. So you remember we had the cornrow going in, out, and in. So this is what I mean by in. So the last time it went backwards was here. So now this is going to carry on all the way down there. And this again is regular way of stitching cornrow, stitching weaves on a regular cornrow. So nothing new has happened. Now don't forget what we're trying to do here. We're trying to create a side parting from a full head of braid, full head of weave. So this is me stitching all the way now to the front. Okay, so we've done quite a lot. You can see from back to back. And you can see her face. So it's developing slowly. But what I want you to see here is how I actually do turn the weft backwards in order to carry on. This is where lots of people again get it wrong, because they don't get it, they don't turn at the right place, and so the hair starts to recede in. So how this has curved in. Okay, so remember this is the end. Then I'll show you what I've done there. Now that's where you can see how much you've narrowed down that opening. Okay, so that's the part we finished sealing in. So now we're coming back to all the, you remember when we were stitching very close to each other. And so you can now decide where you want that side parting to be. Within that space that we had, where we became really close to each other, you have so much choices. Yeah, so you can see that I've tried opening as many places as possible, and each time you're just seeing a full coverage. Nothing is showing the tracks anymore. Once you've done that, next thing is to brush it. Okay, so that's a curling tongue and I've got it all heated up. So I'm being very careful because it's synthetic hair, so I don't want to burn it all up. So what this does is just make sure that it's completely clear where you've created. And that's it. So your demarcation is very clear now. And that's your side parting. Now what I never recommend this style for center parting, because for center parting, either she leaves her hair open or she gets the lace closure weave we're talking about, lace closure. So for side parting, yes, this is absolutely brilliant. And this is what lots of people go for when they want that full head weave, but they want to be able to open it on the side without having to stick out their natural hair, or like I see most people try to do, is just leave that cornrow in between. And that's the most ridiculous thing you can ever see. So why not do something like this for your clients? Why not give them a gorgeous look like this? So there you have it. Amazing look that you just saw every step of the way. Saw how this was created. And this just gives you an idea, like this is virgin hair wearing. You can see how her hair falls as well, even if it's synthetic hair. Now, like I said, when we started, you have clients who equally want to look as good, but they don't want to spend as much money buying the hair extension as this will cost. But with you creating this amazing look, they have beautiful hairstyle without the huge price tag. But of course, you are earning good money giving them the kind of look they want. And when you continuously do this, that's money in your hand. And that's what we represent. We always say to you, empower your hands. And you saw what my hand created. Your hand can create that too. That's our mission for you. That's our message to you. That's our wish for you. That's our dream for you. Right now, with unemployment everywhere and people just getting fed up, not knowing what to do, your hands is there. Just engage it. Do things like this and people will be happy to sit down and pay good money for it. So thank you for buying this DVD, because we know this is going to give you quite a lot of something to keep you busy and bring money in. And there's going to be many more videos like this, you know, giving you all the latest ways of working with hair. So we love working with you. We love to support you. And we thank you too for supporting us by buying the DVD. So we look forward to seeing you in the next one. Follow us on Instagram. We always throw in short clips of what we do. And we'll show you students at work doing their own work as well. World of Braiding, that's the name of the Instagram. I have Joy Fido as well, where I show other things. But World of Braiding is focusing on training you and giving you skills. So we look forward to seeing you in the next one. Thank you so much and God bless.